Hey, what's up, everybody? We're here at the world famous Exploratorium in San Francisco. And before we get started, I need some water. Why am I eating chips in the first place? Excuse me, ma'am, do you guys have a water fountain somewhere? Right over there? Thank you so much. Well, folks, as water becomes more scarce, drinking toilet water is going to become a reality for a lot of us. So get used to it.
Is it just me? Or does it seem like there's more news about water shortages? Like, take what's happening in Cape Town, South Africa, where the city is in such short supply that they're limiting residents' water and fining people who go over. It's so bad that government officials are even showing up to the most heavy water users' houses and publicly shaming them. Just imagine, like, they just kick down your door with cameras everywhere, like, yo, you flushed your toilet 10 times. It's not even 9 a.m. yet. That's a show I might watch, actually. And I live in California, where we just came out of a really long drought, where we had big water restrictions, like bans on watering lawns or washing cars with hoses that don't have shut-off nozzles. On the bright side, it was a good excuse to have a dirty car. So with all these stories about water shortages, is the world running out of water? First, I want to acknowledge that lack of clean water is already a major problem for many parts of the world. Over 2 billion people end up having to drink contaminated water because they don't have access to the clean stuff. And because of this, more than 500,000 children die every year. In fact, ensuring access to clean water and sanitation is a major goal of the United Nations. Now, it's no secret that we all need water to survive. We drink it, we grow our food with it, we bathe in it, and some of us even use it for water balloon fights. And it's also used in a lot of industries like manufacturing and power plants. And because water is so awesome, we're using it up faster than we can replace it. According to the World Health Organization, by 2025, half of the world's population won't have enough clean water to meet their basic needs during certain times of the year. And that's a major problem. So you might be thinking, wait a minute, isn't water a renewable resource? I mean, we all learned about the water cycle. Water doesn't just go away, it just changes states as it evaporates, rains or snows, and melts. And what about all those crazy rainstorms and hurricanes we keep hearing about? Those are dropping tons of water on the planet, so we can't possibly be running short, can we? Those are all really good points, but it's a little more complicated than that. I'll let my robot friend Blocko explain.
Thanks, Myles. Hey there, everyone. I'm Blocko from Life Noggin. So a big part of the problem is that not all the water on Earth is usable. About 95.6% of it is in the oceans, which isn't exactly drinkable. Of the remaining fresh water, about 68% is stored in ice and glaciers. So most of the Earth's drinking water comes from freshwater lakes, rivers, streams, and groundwater. Groundwater is all the water stored below the Earth's surface. In soil, in between rocks, and in aquifers. As water evaporates, rains, snows, and melts, it's constantly moving. So some places can get lots of water, while others are super dry.
Thanks for that, Blocko. It was good seeing you.
You too, Myles. And don't forget to keep on thinking.
And you stay above the noise. Man, I love that guy. So as Blocko explained, water availability varies by region. So it's not like one place that's flush with water can necessarily give it to a faraway place in need. And even when we get crazy rainstorms in drought-stricken areas, all that rain doesn't necessarily soak into the ground where it can replenish groundwater and make itself useful. Instead, it can create big problems like flooding and mudslides. So while the world's not running out of water per se, as our population grows, the demand for water will increase and lack of usable water will become a real issue for a lot of places. In fact, according to the United Nations, by 2030, lack of water could end up displacing 700 million people. That's more than double the population of the US. So why is this happening? For one, some places are pumping their groundwater faster than rain and snowmelt can refill it. In fact, some cities like Mexico City, Beijing, and even places in California's Central Valley are sinking as the groundwater is drained. Another reason? Just bad water management. I mean, not to point fingers or anything, but that's partially why Cape Town is in this whole water mess. The national government didn't really respond well to the city's warnings about water shortages. Then there's the problem of lack of infrastructure or just bad infrastructure. In the US, leaking pipes cause us to waste 6 billion gallons of treated water a day. That's equal to about 9,000 Olympic-sized swimming pools of water that goes to waste daily. That's crazy. And climate change isn't helping the matter. As Earth warms up, scientists anticipate that droughts and floods will become more intense. Okay, so that's the bad news. But the good news is we can do something about it. For starters, we can get better at conserving water, like replacing water-guzzling grass lawns with native plants, taking shorter showers, fixing leaks, buying water-efficient appliances, and if it's yellow, let it mellow. And this actually works. During California's drought, urban areas cut water use by 24% using these kinds of conservation efforts. Then, there's desalination plants that turn ocean water into fresh water, but they're also super expensive and energy intensive. My personal favorite, though, is to get better at recycling wastewater. Israel, for example, recycles 87% of their wastewater and uses it to water crops. The next highest country is Spain, which recycles only 20% of their water. And in California, we're getting closer to actually drinking our recycled toilet water. Like Orange County super cleans it and pumps it into the ground, which eventually makes its way to the drinking supply. Don't worry though, it's not like you're just dipping your cup into the toilet. This water passes all the health standards and taste tests. Way to go, Orange County. So we want to know, how worried are you about water shortages? And what kinds of things would you be willing to do to reduce your water use? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks guys, bye. And before I go, we gotta give a big thanks to Life Noggin and Blocko. You guys are awesome as always. Thanks for sharing your wealth of knowledge with us. And if you like this video, you should check out our video on why vaping is so popular and our other video on if trolls are born or made. Whoa. Till next time, guys.